Just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke tastes, zero calories. Enjoy everything. We're ready to get this one underway as the teams are lined up for the opening kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 25. Patterson's the kind of guy that you want to get involved early and often, Kirk, and get the crowd in and get it behind him right now.
Absolutely. I mean, because of his big playability, you want to be able to have a chance playing at home. Get the ball in his hands. Let him make the big play or two. Just the potential of him making those big plays. This offense seems to feed off of that energy.
It's a great play by the defense, but you know, it really makes you wonder, was there a miscommunication up front by the offensive line? They just seemed to allow the defensive line to get through, and the running back didn't have much of a chance at all.
Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on 24. They'll bring him down around the 24-yard line. And the halfback's got nowhere to go. In the shotgun and five wideouts. Throws complete. He's got room to work. And he's tackled at the 32-yard line. That was a good pass and catch there, but still not enough for the first down.
That's not an easy conversion here on third down for the offense. All the defense has to do is stay back, keep everything in front of them, come up and make a tackle.
Tackle made at the 50-yard line. So the offense will come out for their first possession.
Good field position for their first possession of the ball game. Let's see if they can capitalize off of it.
Big opening. And he's taken down right around the 42-yard line. The stop around the 40-yard line. Buckner picks up only about 2 yards with that grab.
Well, they got to him in a hurry, but it was just a little bit too late. That's a nice first down pass.
Kill, kill, kill!
And they hit him in the backfield. To that quickly, and down he goes at about the 25-yard line. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
Tackle after a decent run up the gut. Solid 5-yard pickup there on the halfback option. Gets the ball here and brought down in the backfield. From the 26-yard line, it's third down. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. Tackle at the 23-yard line. Ohio is looking to go up by 3. Kicks away, and he nails the long field goal.
Yeah, he got some good leg behind it, and he kicked an accurate ball right between the goalposts.
3-0, Ohio. He really got a hold of that kick. Brought down at the 18. The Bobcats are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
Time left, You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
Oklahoma!
Tackle made around the 31-yard line.
The offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
From their own 31-yard line, it's first down. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Brought down at about the 37-yard line. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. Here's a screen pass, gets it to the back. He gets hit out of bounds around the 39-yard line. Cox is back deep to return the punt. Tackle at the 29. They'll come back out with some confidence from having put through the field goal last time. Ohio has a three-point lead. Second and 10, ball on the 29-yard line. Knock him down for a loss. So the defense gets him to go three and out.
Good job here defensively forcing this incomplete pass.
Wilson is waiting for the snap. This one might be coming back, folks. Let's check out the penalty. That one's going to put him way back.
You just can't block a player from behind like that, or it's going to cost you.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 27-yard line.
Has some daylight.
He's tackled at about the 39-yard line. The 41. 2 yards there on the option keeper.
And that was the junior corner who'll get credit with that tackle.
From their own 41-yard line. Second down. Nice job by the running back, and that'll get him 7, maybe 8 yards. Cox is back deep to return.
He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
Boy, neither offense can find any kind of rhythm so far, Herbie.
Yeah, it almost feels like the two offenses are just kind of feeling their way right now, allowing both these defenses just to dominate the game.
Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Ohio holds a field goal lead. And they'll bring him down behind the line. To his receiver. They'll bring him down at the 27. And he's tackled around the 46-yard line.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
Makes it to the 48-yard line. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. Get him in the backfield for a loss. How about the play of this defensive end?
This is just solid run defense here. They get a great push up front, not allowing the runner to have much room to work with. And at the end, they're able to wrap him up.
So at the end of one, the Bobcats lead 3-0. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. Ohio is up by 3. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. He takes it right side for a good gain. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
But you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
From their own 31-yard line. First down. And he hits him hard at the 41-yard line. Trouble, but he can't shake the defense.
I think the quarterback here, even though he came up with a sack and he's on his back, he's also guilty here of not getting a better pre-snap read. You know, a lot of quarterbacks will get caught up in their size and their arm strength and how they throw the football, but the really good quarterbacks bring the intangibles to the table, and that means recognizing a blitz and affecting the offensive line and making the right call to adjust the protection. That time, he didn't do that.
He's hit and taken down. First and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line.
One, two, nine. complete, and he stopped immediately. And the defense gives up some free yards to the offense.
You know, penalties can ruin a team's chances to win if they commit too many.
First and 10, ball on the 18. He gets out to about the 15-yard line. The back gets three on the carry. And this is the ninth play of the current drive.
Check 26, check 26. Six, man. Check girls, check girls, check girls.
He's gobbled up in the backfield.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
And they'll look to convert here on another third down. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Kicks up, and he's got it. Looks like they're ready for the kick. From the 5-yard line, he's out to the 30, at the corner, the 50. Inside the 30, knocked out of bounds at the 24-yard line. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Gains his way to the 16-yard line. On the ground, and he won't get back to the line.
That was just a case of one lineman dominating another and making the play.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Scrambling, and now he's got room to run. Excellent open field tackle.
Hey, let's go, let's go. They're not ready. Let's go, let's go. Get up, get up.
Back to the running back, and he gets nowhere. Third down again. They go to the screen here, and the halfback's got it. And he tackles him hard at the 10-yard line. Ohio could take the lead with this field goal. It's up, and they tack on 3 points. They line up to kick this one away. It's fielded at the 2. And down he goes at the 29-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Scooped up by the defense. Nice run, and he's brought down.
The running back won't be happy that he lost the ball. He's got to forget about it and get ready for the next series. His offense is going to need him again.
They picked up 3 points on their last possession, and they've got great field position to work from here. Ohio is up a field goal. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. It's second and 15. Ball on the 30. And he's taken down at the 22. The stop at the 16. So it's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here. Is up and the field goal is good. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20 and he's taken down at the 28-yard line. Right now this game's got all the makings of maybe being a nail biter.
Yeah, this game just feels like it's going to go well into the second half, probably into the fourth quarter. You almost have a feel that maybe one of the defenses may have to score a touchdown to be able to win this game.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers.
He scrambled. He's to the 40. He's knocked out of bounds right around the 42-yard line.
So we've got a first down after a great running play. Now he's flushed and they got him. The pressure got to him that time.
Well, they brought the heat here and the linebacker was able to spring free for a big play.
Going right to his tailback. And down he goes, right around the 46-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 32. Setting up blockers, or running backs got it on the screen. Tackle at the 42-yard line. He'll try to change the field position and especially not get it to the end zone. Punt, Kirk.
Yeah, Brad, that was nice. So now they're looking at a long way to go to even think about a score.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. And they get nice yardage on that run. We played a half of football. Ohio leads 9-3.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. This game's been everything we anticipated it being, each team matching each other blow for blow, just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two games match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is, and it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground, and which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollack can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. Taken at the 5. Tackle made at the 30.
This offense is just going to be kicking themselves. They're moving the ball very well. In fact, they're getting into their opponent's territory. The only problem is they're not finishing off the drives with touchdowns. They're having to settle for field goals. That could eventually catch up to them.
So they're just about set to get the game going again. Ohio up 6. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. Taken down at the 31-yard line. From their own 31-yard line, it's third down. Going deep, lays it out there. Found his man. Tackle made at the 12-yard line.
The offense caught him flat-footed to convert that third and long. You can tell by the coach's reaction that that is a huge disappointment.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. Work the left, and he carries the ball for a nice game. He's tackled at the 4. The 3-yard line.
Fourth down. They're going to go for the easy 3 here. The Bobcats saw one of their top players going down earlier. Looks like he's going to be able to get back in there. Ohio is up by 6. Kicks away, and it's through the uprights. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. From his own goal line. Across the 30. He's tackled at the 34. The Bobcats continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Pushed out of bounds, right around the 36-yard line. From their own 36-yard line, it's second down. They'll bring him down at about the 33-yard line.
Roger, Roger. 49 to Mike, watch 49.
and he throws right away. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
That is money in the bank. Sometimes you just can't stop a good combination.
First and 10, ball on the 49-yard line. He's got it with room to run. And he's tackled at the 23. From the 23-yard line, first down. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. Strike to his receiver, no good.
That's a miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signals straight.
They'll line it up again on third down. Rolls out and a leaping interception by the corner.
It looked like the pass was sailing out of reach, but he just climbed the ladder and made a spectacular interception.
Gets out to about the 9-yard line. Looking for the corner. He gets out to about the 17-yard line. Tries to get around the corner. Gets out to around the 28. Heading for the corner. Nice run to the outside. Run there as they work the outside. And they hit him in the backfield. From their own 37-yard line. Second down.
Red two.
And he's immediately tackled. Gains his way to the 29-yard line. Gains his way to the 20-yard line.
Larry, Larry.
out to the right and is brought down in the backfield. So it's second and 14. Ball on the 24. Gets out to about the 22-yard line. Tosses out to the tailback on the screen. And they push him out around the 18-yard line. So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. There's a little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a 5-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
Kicks up, and it sails through the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. From the 5-yard line, brought down at the 28. The quarterback comes back on the field, and I'm sure he's hoping to make up for that interception on the last drive.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
Here's the halfback on the screen. They bring him down in the backfield. From their own 28-yard line, it's second down. Fires out to his wideout. He's hit and taken down. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
Slings it, and he's tackled right away. It's first and 10. Ball on the 50. Nice run there. Around 4 yards there on the quarterback keeper. And this is still anyone's ball game as we head into the final quarter of play. Ohio's lead is 12. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Fires out quick. It's picked off.
This quarterback better start making better decisions in the passing game. Otherwise, this corner will come up with even more picks in the future.
From their own 44-yard line, it's first down. They make the stop around the 48-yard line. Nice job by the running back, and that'll get him 7, maybe 8 yards.
Handsome daylight.
Runs it right. Nice pickup. And he is drilled at the 41-yard line. runs it left for a decent gain. Gain as he works the right side. And he's taken down at the 35-yard line.
When this guy gets his arms around a ball carrier, I don't care who it is. He's not getting away.
Second down, 15 to go. Ball on the 35. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. Knocked out of bounds at the 26-yard line. Scrambling, and he can't get away from the pressure. There's a player hurt. It doesn't look to be that bad. It's fourth down. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. It's up. No good. He hooked it right. We'll have to see now how the offense responds this time after throwing a pick on their last drive.
And I don't think this defense will lay down lightly. They're going to try to continue to rattle this guy.
Tackle at the 43. From their own 43-yard line. First down. Goes at the 44. And they get nice yardage on that run. It's second down, 5 to go. Ball on the 39-yard line. Makes it out to about the 29. Tackle outside after a nice pickup. Need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Caught and shoved out of bounds. Defense would like to come up with another big play like they did in the last trip. For this offense in the red zone with the interception. It's a great run, and he's brought down in the backfield. And this play is number 8 on the drive. He's taken down at about the 7-yard line. So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. Just under 3 to go in regulation. He makes it out to maybe the 7-yard line.
I got one.
Defense and their short yardage package. He fights forward to about the 7.
Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Up the middle for a nice gain. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Decent run here, right side.
The defense has got to do a better job of being more aggressive. You know, this offense doesn't seem to be in much of a hurry. They're working the clock. You know the chances are they're going to run the football. That allows the defense to pin their ears back and get aggressive. It really comes down to the defensive linemen holding up against the offensive line and the linebackers and safeties crashing downhill and making plays against the run game.
And he makes it out to about the 17-yard line. Buffaloes call their final timeout. Third and 11 here. Ball on the 17. He's tackled at the 36. He goes over 100 yards in receptions.
Well, this guy is such a big part of this offense. If he doesn't get his numbers, they usually don't have much success moving the football.
From their own 36-yard line, first down. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Ross gets it on the counter, brought down at the 33-yard line.
I'd look for this offense to go back to some more straightforward between the tackles running. They want to win this thing in the trenches.
Here's the halfback. Tackle made at the 31-yard line.
The defense was playing run all the way right there, and it paid off for them.
There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. Here's the eighth play of the series. The Bulls, I'm sure, are secure in the knowledge that despite this setback today, they still have one of the best players in the country.
Well, this is a devastating loss, but it's one that they're going to have to put behind them. And as you said, they still have one of the best players in the country. They don't need to deviate their plan. Get back to really what they know, and that's getting the ball to their star player. And next week, I'm sure they'll be fine.
So that wraps things up for us, for EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.